Hi. This segment has been made to demonstrate proper flushing and blood withdrawal from a central line. It is intended to teach the principles of line care, but not intended to be an instructional video.
If you are watching this video, it is because you or someone close to you has a central line. Central lines are IVs, which allow medications to be given into large veins in the body, or to draw blood for lab work.
While healthcare providers are trained in caring for this type of device, there can be differences between providers as to how this care is performed. Even though we may not train you to perform flushes or lab draws off a line independently, it is important to know how to correctly care for your line. Before we show this procedure, let's review how it is done.
Before you do anything with the line, your nurse needs to make sure that it's safe to use. They will ask the patient if there has been any pain or problems with the line, or any bleeding or discharge from the site. The nurse will look at the site of the line to see if there's any redness or drainage at the insertion site, which could be a sign of infection, or signs that something is wrong with the line.
Flushing a central line requires saline flushes and alcohol pads. Depending on the line, the doctor may want your line to get heparin, an anticoagulant, to prevent the line from clotting off.
Before anyone does anything to a central line, they need to wash their hands. Good hand hygiene is one of the most important ways to prevent infection.
Next, the nurse needs to clean the cap with an alcohol pad. The hub of the cap needs to be scrubbed for a total of 15 seconds. After cleaning, the nurse will attach the syringe with saline and unclamp the line. Then, they will flush with the saline. It should go nice and easy and it should not hurt.
Sometimes patients say they get a funny taste or a cool feeling when the saline is going into the line. Then the line is clamped and the syringe is removed.
If required, your nurse will flush your line with heparin at this time.
Now that we have flushed the line, we can talk about drawing labs off of it. While a central line is necessary for your care, it can increase your risk for infection. To minimize that risk, we will use a vein to draw blood whenever possible. This is the safest way to prevent infection.
In some instances, however, doctors will elect to have their patients have labs drawn off of central lines. Let's quickly review how to draw blood off a central line.
To draw blood off a line, first it is flushed with saline. After flushing the line, the nurse will draw back and waste some of the blood they withdraw from your line. This removes all the blood in the line that is diluted with saline that was just flushed in. This will make sure that the lab results are accurate.
After pulling off a waste, the sample is removed from the line. The line will be cleaned with an alcohol pad, and then the line is flushed with normal saline.
Notice that he or she followed all the essential steps: good hand washing, scrubbing the hub for 15 seconds, flushing the line with saline, drawing off a waste, drawing the lab sample are all essential steps towards properly flushing a line and drawing blood.
Most importantly, they did not contaminate by touching the cap to anything after it's been cleaned. If the end of your hub bumps into something, your nurse will perform an additional 15-second scrub prior to attaching it to anything.
All of these steps are essential in performing proper line care. While some aspects may vary from place to place and provider to provider, these steps are crucial and should be followed whenever your line is used.
It is important to keep in mind that you are an important partner in your healthcare. It is your line. Ultimately, you are responsible for making sure it is cared for properly. So don't hesitate to speak up if you see care that you aren't familiar with or that makes you uncomfortable. You will be given specific instructions for your line and its care. Be sure to follow up with your doctor if you have any questions. Thank you.